Hey, what's up guys? You're watching Theo Joe Tech, and in this video, I'm talking about 2.4 versus 5 gigahertz on Wi-Fi routers. If you've been shopping for a router anytime in the last 5 years, you probably know that they ship dual band routers that allow you to connect on either frequency. But what is really the difference? Are there advantages and disadvantages to either one? Of course, the answer is yes, but what are those differences? Because there is not necessarily always a reason to use 5 gigahertz. Sometimes it's actually better to use 2.4. That's what I'm gonna talk about in this video. First of all, yes, 5 gigahertz is faster in general, but not exactly for the reason you might think. Most people assume that, oh, well, 5 gigahertz is a higher frequency. That means it can transmit data faster, but that's not exactly the case. You see, 5 gigahertz or 2.4 are the carrier wave frequencies. That's the general frequency of the wave it's putting out, but the information is encoded or modulated in that frequency about the same way between the two. So just because it is a higher frequency doesn't mean that it is carrying more information per second necessarily by the frequency itself. The real reason 5 gigahertz is faster is because the way it uses different channels and how they're arranged. You see, with channels in Wi-Fi, they are basically small ranges of frequencies that are used to transmit data. So obviously the router isn't using exactly 5 gigahertz for everything. There is different frequency ranges that are possibly to be used. In 5 gigahertz, they made it so there's no overlap between any of the channels, which is not the case for 2.4. And also there's much less crowding of frequencies and transmissions in each of the channels because 5 gigahertz is used less than 2.4. So overall, it just opens up more bandwidth that is able to be used on each individual channel of the Wi-Fi. And that, along with improved protocols for transmitting data, such as being able to use multiple streams on different channels, just makes 5 gigahertz faster in general. Another advantage of 5 gigahertz that I briefly touched on before is wireless interference. The 2.4 gigahertz range is very crowded and used by many other household devices, not just Wi-Fi, which takes up a lot of the airspace. You've got things like cordless phones, Bluetooth, even car alarm sensors, and microwave ovens. All of these are in the same 2.4 gigahertz range as Wi-Fi, and that just crowds the space and makes it tougher for the signal to get through. All this interference could potentially mean you get packet loss, poor signal, that sort of thing. But with 5 gigahertz, very few other devices use it at all in your house. So certainly less than 2.4. So that means that you're gonna have a much stronger signal and more availability of each channel, and it's just gonna be better in general. So now you might be thinking, oh, 5 gigahertz sounds better in every way. No reason not to use it ever. Not exactly the case, obviously. The main disadvantage of 5 gigahertz is it has a significantly shorter range than 2.4. You see, in general, lower frequency radio waves are better able to pass through walls than higher frequency waves. So if you're a couple rooms away, further away from the router, you're probably gonna have a stronger signal with the 2.4 gigahertz, probably much more so than 5 gigahertz. So if you have a device that's really close to the router, then yeah, it's probably better to just use 5 gigahertz. But if you're pretty far away, 2.4 gigahertz might have a much better signal. However, you have to consider that the speed increase of 5 gigahertz might offset that weaker signal. In most cases though, you'll probably just want to do a test between the two to figure it out. Every environment is going to be different. For example, if you have a ton of 2.4 gigahertz interference, then maybe even the 5 gigahertz will go further than 2.4, you don't really know. You'll also probably wanna consider the type of device you're using. If you're using something that doesn't really require a lot of speed at all, but will more rely on the signal strength, then yeah, you probably wanna use 2.4 gigahertz just so you can consistently get a better signal. Now, another important thing to note between 2.4 and 5 gigahertz is the type of protocol you're using. If you're using AC, that only uses 5 gigahertz. It doesn't support 2.4 gigahertz. Of course, it's backwards compatible, but if you're connecting, for example, a 2.4 gigahertz connection to a AC router, then it's only gonna be using N, not AC. If you wanna take advantage of the AC protocol, it has to be 5 gigahertz. Wireless N, on the other hand, does support both 2.4 and 5 gigahertz, so you just wanna be aware that if you have an AC router and you're only using it for 2.4 gigahertz, you're not really getting your money's worth. So I guess that's about it, all you need to know about it. If you guys have any more questions, you can let me know in the comment section. You're probably better on Twitter. I'm usually looking at that more often. And if you did enjoy this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up so I know you enjoyed it. Also, if you want to keep watching, I've got some other videos I think you'll like on the right-hand side. You can just click those or look in the description for the same link, like if you're on a phone. And if you want to subscribe, I make a couple videos every week, so it should be worth it. Looking forward to hearing from you guys, either here on YouTube or on Twitter. So thank you for watching. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.